Hi there, I'm Heather Ackmann, here to show you one of the cool new Office 365 features recently unveiled in the Office Insider Fast program. Automatic alt text suggestions. Just one of the many new awesome features Microsoft has been pushing out over the last few months aimed at improving accessibility across the Microsoft Office suite of products. And this one feature I wanted to show you because it is really kind of cool. So here I am in a blank PowerPoint presentation, and I'm just going to drag in a photo of a kitty cat. And there it is right there. You can see it generating some alt text right there. A cat that is laying down and looking at the, let me drag that out, looking at the camera. That's the alt text. And for those of you who don't know what alt text is or what it's there for people who are visually impaired, people who can't see, people who rely on screen readers to tell them what is there on the screen. These screen readers look at the objects, and every object may or may not have text associated with it. Objects that do have alternative text associated with that object, that text is read out describing what that object looks like or what it is. Otherwise, it's this generic picture1.jpg that may or may not be meaningful to that person. A more descriptive description, like a cat that is laying down looking at the camera, is very beneficial. So the fact that this is automatically generated and I didn't have to type this out or describe the image itself is a huge benefit to me. Because let's face it, I'm lazy. I don't do this all the time. And that is dead on accurate to what that image looks like. Now, if it's not accurate, if I want more information about this, I can click right on there. I don't have to go hunting around the interface looking for that alt text description. I just click right on that banner and it pops up that window for me. And I can click right on there and add any more details editing that text so simply. It even tells me down below that this description was generated with high confidence. This is an amazing feature. Now let's try it with some other images and see how it performs. So let me delete this little cute kitty cat. Grab this dog. All right. Brown and black dog sitting in front of a door. Yeah, that is exactly what that picture does. This is pretty good. Clicking on that. Yeah, high confidence. Pretty good. Let's try some other images. Let's give it a hard one. Let's give it some athletic photos. Here we go, something with a little blur to it. Oh, this one not quite right. A person riding a skateboard up the side of a road, yet it's a blurry background with a person that is clearly jogging. Not quite there, and it says it's generated with high confidence. So this one we'd have to go in and edit a little bit. So that one it didn't quite get right. Let's try another one. Let's try some food. Here we go. Bucket of fried chicken. Oh, a cup of coffee. Way off. It says it was generated with high confidence. That is not a cup of coffee. Now I want fried chicken. Yeah, so clearly it's not perfect. But even when it's not perfect, it is so easy for me, the user, to jump in, click the photo, edit that alt text. Whereas before, I didn't even know just adding images that this was even something that I should be doing. So big kudos to Microsoft for this feature. I see this being a big improvement considering what was there. And you know what? I see this technology only getting better from here on out.